afternoon, Sir Francis.
Good afternoon.
Francis!
Phyllis, let your dragon slip.
Waitress, would you bring me a champagne cocktail?
Yes, Mrs. Spofford.
Just a moment, waitress. My mother is to have nothing but moxie.
I understand, Mr. Spofford. Thank you, Mr. Spofford.
Doctor's orders, Mother dear.
Waitress, never mind about the moxie.
And here it is.
So, you've the exclusive rights to this thing, Mr. Gage?
Exclusive! And it ought to revolutionize the garment industry. Young man, there's an excellent article in Health magazine, Vegetables for Virility. And don't neglect your breathing, boy.
We do it all the time, sir.
So long, Tarzan.
You know, I just discovered the possibilities of this thing back in 1918.
Francis!
Yes, my dear.
Courtesy of the wall.
Waitress, please, just one teensy weensy champagne cocktail.
Sorry, Mrs. Spofford. Poor old Mrs. Spofford, she's the richest woman in Philadelphia and has someone let her have a cocktail.
Madam!
Side of the tracks, find a challenge. does, Mumblebit.
No, but I'm afraid he's going to find out anyhow.
Gee, if it's that bad, you should have told us sitting right on Daddy's lap.
Oh, dear.
Another one, Miss Lee.
Throw it overboard. Wait, let me have it. It's from Gus again. I've just heard about your tangle with the law in Little Rock. Stop. Pop insists on questioning everyone in Little Rock. Who knew you when?
Stop. That's all I want to hear.
Tangle with the law? What does that mean?
Dorothy, there are some thoughts a girl's brain should just never dwell on. And if Mr. Esmond had rather listened to small town gossip than be married to a girl like I, then he should just sit on his father's lap and go straight to the devil in his father's little chair.
And the hell with Gus.
The hell with Mr. Esmond. Only, now we gotta use this trip to get somewhere.
We're getting to Paris, aren't we?
No, I need to meet gentlemen with futures. One for you, and for me.
You have the exclusive rights to this thing, Mr. Gaines. I certainly have. I'm on my way now to introduce it to the Parisian dress trade.
Mr. Gage, that zipper's gonna ruin buttons, and I'm glad.
Well, thanks.
But we haven't been introduced yet, have we?
Why, no. I've already opened my first factory in the East. New York, to be exact.
Well, anyhow, that was a nice try.
Waitress, bring me a champagne cocktail, please.
Sorry, Mrs. Crawford, I have my order.
Well, are you the famous Mrs. Crawford from Philadelphia?
Why, yes, my dear.
I just love to know the mother of such an attractive son as we're supposed to have.
So you've heard something about my Henry, have you?
Why, yes, I just love to hear it all from the original source. Waitress, a bottle of champagne?
Oh, goodness!
But I can't drink it on deck. Henry might see me.
Very well. Waitress, bring it to my cabin.
Yes,
ma'am. Oh, you're so thoughtful. No, you should drink champagne indoors anyway. It's always hits when we get out in the air. Dorothy? Call me Doc?
What is it?
I want you to meet a new friend of mine, Mrs. Fogg.
Some other time, hon.
But I've got her son all picked out for you.
Thanks, but you take him.
But I've got Mr. Gaines, the zipper cane.
Come, Doc!
Sure.
Will you join us to sleep?
No, thanks. But I hope you gentlemen win all the games in the Olympics and make lots and lots of money.
But we don't do it for money.
You don't?
That would ruin our amateur standing.
Well, what do you do it for then?
A trophy.
Oh, a trophy.
That's great. You know, you're just like me.
Hold a car down, I'm all up.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, Sir Francis.
Good afternoon.
Francis! If you don't stop laughing, I'm going to lock you in the cabin.
Oh, Phyllis, not that. You did that last time. Anyway, I was only trying to promote business for you, my dear.
I am perfectly capable of finding my own business prospects.
But aren't you trying to sell your diamond tiara?
I'll have none of your feeble excuses, please.
I shall say no more.
Goodbye, Sir Francis.
Goodbye.
Francis!
Hello, Mr. Stoffer.
I beg your pardon?
A flat tire.
Stuffed shirt.
Steward. I can't find my mother anywhere, but I found her hat on your table. Have you seen her?
Yes, your mother was with Miss Lee, sir.
Miss Lee? Is she one of the Lees of Virginia?
I do not know, sir. But if you have not met her, you are missing out on quite a lot.
Oh, she's that sort, is she?
Oh, yes, sir.
Well, that's just the thing I've got to guard Mother against.
Thanks very much. Don't mention it. I have to crack this. Excuse me.
What on earth is she doing?
She says she has to practice.
Practice what?
Memorial Glee Club.
Oh, brother.
And when he
he gets here. I found his favorite record so we can play it.
I can hardly wait.
Entree.
Lady Beekman sends her compliments and she said she'd like to see you.
Tell Lady Beekman I'll see her in half an hour.
The holy heck you on with her.
I heard she has a delightful diamond tiara that she'd like to sell to Americans for $5,000.
I thought those Beekmans had all the dough in England.
They do, but no English lady is so wealthy she can't sell something to we Americans.
Is one of you ladies Miss Lorelei Lee?
Oh, that's I.
Miss Lee, I'm Henry Spofford.
Oh, Mr. Spofford, I've heard nothing but things about you. And so is my chaperone.
Chaperone?
Yes, Miss Shaw has been so anxious to meet you.
She has?
Hi there, how about a drink?
A Vichy water.
Not at the moment, thanks. I'm looking for my mother and found her hat on the sun deck. Someone told me that when she left there, she was with you?
Well, she was somewhere.
You see, I brought Mother on this trip because of the high condition of her nerves. And naturally, I want to keep her away from the excitement of the younger set.
Oh, there's nothing exciting about poor little us.
There might be two schools of thought about that, Miss Lee.
Thank you.
How do you happen to have that record?
Oh, it's my chaperone's favorite.
Really, Miss Shaw?
Why not?
Quite a history at the college I attended.
Yes?
They play it every year at the senior prom, so we'd rather make a feature of it in the glee club which I conduct.
How extraordinary!
We say it's responsible for, to be frank, more romances in Philadelphia than any other composition.
To be frank, I didn't know you guys had romance in Philadelphia.
Philadelphia might surprise you.
Couldn't you just sing us the words?
They're rather provocative.
Okay, go ahead and provoke us.
Dorothy, she's doing.
We're just a kiss apart, and yet we dance on and on.
My dear!
Lady Beekman, I was just telling my chaperone about
Chaperone?
That's me, kid.
Oh, I see.
Did you bring your diamond tiara with you, Lady Beekman?
Of course, I always have it handy. One never knows when one is likely to meet some delightful American. It's been in the family for generations. You'll never find another like it.
Oh, I don't mind that. The thing about diamonds is they always look new.
Oh, and I thought I had everything until I saw a diamond tiara.
Darling, isn't it divine?
Yeah, and the good thing about a tiara is you can wear it with anything.
The only thing is, I don't seem to have $5,000.
Oh, surely. There must be someone who always spoke to Redlinda too.
You mean borrow money? On a boat? From a stranger?
No, of course not. From some friend.
She's right. A friend should get the preference.
Well, Lady Peekman, I'll see what I can do about things.
Take your time, my dear. I'm sure you'll find a way. Au revoir, my clever little creature. Goodbye!
Goodbye!
Well, Lady Peekman sure gave me a hint as to who to ask to borrow it from.
She did.
Entree.
Did you ring, mademoiselle?
Oui, Pierre. Will you please pay Sir Francis Beekman?
Holy cats!
Tell him I'd like to see him in half an hour. Then go to the florist and buy me a bunch of flowers. When he gets here, bring in some champagne cocktails and the flowers. But don't tell him I sent them to myself.
Floraline, I don't get you. Here we are in a boat loaded with every nationality in the world, and you have to go after an Englishman.
Well, darling, I always say that spending money is a habit. And if a girl could get Sir Francis started spending, then he might get some quite good habits.
Peek-a-boo!
Mrs. Spofford!
Peek-a-boo to you, Mrs. Spofford, and here's your hat.
Oh, do I have to go? I'm afraid you do.
Your girlfriend here's got a business day.
All right. I hate this hat.
I don't blame you. You've got to be the Queen of England to get away with a hat like that.
Would you care to follow mine? Oh, my eye.
Lovely.
Marvelous. Although, it would fit better if your hair was bobbed.
Why not bob it?
No, darling, don't go putting ideas in her head.
And stop putting them in mine.
Have you a pair of scissors?
She's asking for it.
Darling, we've done enough to her for one day. But it's my hair.
That's all I want to know.
No, Dorothy, please. You mustn't. Audrey.
Hello, Lorelei.
Hello.
Gloria.
They chased me off the deck. They won't let me practice. Do you think I could do it here?
Well, yes, if that's what you want. Gloria, I hope you won't mind my mentioning it, but you're all over black and blue spots, see?
Oh, I don't mind that. To me, it was a pleasure.
What? A pleasure? Well, wow.
Thank you.
sees it. It's taken 10 years of my age.
And it's gonna put it right back on Henry.
Andre.
Hello, hello, hello.
Good
afternoon,
Francis.
Oh, hello. I'm just gonna sign Mrs. Spofford. He's looking for you.
Is he? Ooh, a champagne.
And they wear this to you, mademoiselle.
Oh, another one of those.
I say, my dear, don't you ever read those?
No, they're just from a gentleman who wants to quarrel.
I see. Well, I give you the health of our beautiful hostess.
And flowers for you, mademoiselle.
Surprise, surprise.
Dorothy, don't let us detain you.
What do you want me to do, step off the ship?
No, dear, the bedroom will do nicely. Flowers?
Flowers?
There's only one gentleman in this whole ship who's kind enough to buy a girl a whole dozen, a whole bunch of flowers.
Well, I don't want you to think that I had anything planned.
If you'd admit you sent them to me, I'd have to call you Piggy.
Well, my dear, if that would make you happy.
Piggy.
I wish this boat weren't getting in Southampton in the morning.
Why not?
Because that's where I have to get off.
Oh.
And tomorrow you'll be in Paris, all merry and bright.
Just think of it, Paris.
I say, my dear, I wish this boat were going the opposite direction.
Maybe it is. Let's look.
No, I mean to South America.
Why?
Maybe we can call Stanley down there.
She can't?
No, I have several extremely large investments in Chile. Have you ever been to Chile?
I don't know. Where is it?
It's in South America.
Oh, you mean that, Chili.
And Lorelei, it has everything.
Thank you.
never been to the Folies Bergère myself, but there's another place I'd like to take you.
No, Folies?
It's very intimate.
Well, just don't tell Lorelei about it, will you?
All right, it'll be our own private haunt. A quaint little Punch and Judy show. The children are just crazy about this.
Thank you.
cocktail party. But you see, Lorelai's never at home.
Oh, she is, eh? Well, I'm Gus Esmond. Didn't she mention I was on my way to join her?
I know.
I've sent wireless after wireless and not a bumble out of her.
Maybe she didn't get them.
Oh, yes, she did. I've had them traced to the boat and here to the hotel. One of those. That will be all right. All of them are. Hello? No, Miss Lee is not here. Who is this? Well, I don't know where she is. Do you know a Lady Beekman?
Why, yes. She and her husband were on the boat with us, but they got off in England.
Well, she's downstairs now, and it sounds like she's good and sore about something. Harry's bar, shape of arms, Folly Berger, Bowie Suez.
Lorelai had fittings this afternoon at Bowie Suez. Would you like me to take you there?
Well, all right, come on.
I'm Lady Beekman, and I've come to see whether Miss Lee is here or not.
Take a look for yourself.
I don't mind a man-sized noise, but these Parisian noises are so darn effeminate. Say, what are you doing here?
I've come to get the tiara of your confederate swindled off me and my husband.
Swindled, she says, and Lorelai paid $5,000 for that top piece.
Then what are you angry about, madam? My husband borrowed those $5,000 from me.
Can you prove that, madam?
Yes, I marked the money.
It might be presumed, madam, that your husband can't be trusted in the first place.
Never mind that, madam. From now on, you'll have my solicitors to deal with.
Boy, oh boy, it's a good thing Lorelai had that tiara insured.
Insured? What a good idea.
Yes, you know Lorelai's motto, safety first.
Mrs. Spofford!
Lorelai!
Bunny, I'd like you to meet Mrs. Spofford. Mrs. Spofford, Mr. Gage.
Delighted, Mrs. Spofford.
Hi there, Tarzan.
Good afternoon, Dorothy.
Look, girls, Bunny had this dress made especially from Bowie Sewers.
By whom, dear?
Lorelai, I believe they pronounce that Bowie Sewer.
That's what he said, Bowie Sewers.
It's the very first Parisian gown to be closed with a zipper.
And so good for a fireman's bride.
Could I pour you a little drink, pal?
No, I thank you.
Well, don't get mad, it was only a suggestion.
Don't you ever drink anything, Mr. Gage?
Nothing alcoholic, Mrs. Spofford. Whenever I feel the need for pick-me-up, I just eat a raw carrot.
I don't smoke, never touch a drink, but I'm sturdy as a note, and I'm always in the pink. I leap out of bed at the crack of dawn, as graceful as an elk, as nimble as a fawn. The life I lead would gladden the heart of Bernard McFadden. From head to toe, I'm alive, I'm a tingle, I'm a glow. With the red corpuscles dancing through my muscles, I'm so full of pep, I overflow. I know the door to paradise is outdoor exercise. In rain or snow, I'm alive, I'm a tingle, I'm a glow. I start my day with a bowl of bran, and the whole day through I'm a I'm alive, I'm a tingle, I'm a glow, ho, ho, I'm alive.
Ta-da!
Bye-bye now.
A toodle alert to you too, Bunny.
Gee, how can that guy eat so many carrots and be so unlike a bunny?
Cozy. Entree!
Oh, hello, Mother.
Hello, Henry.
For you, Miss Lee.
Oh, why thank you, Mr. Spofford.
Gee, thanks.
It's nothing really.
Henry, these two dear children have brought me more sunshine than anyone I have ever known.
How right that is, Mother.
Nothing would make me happier than seeing you married to one of them.
Well, one of us might be a lucky girl, Mrs. Spofford.
Oh, neither of you could care for me.
Why not?
Dorothy?
Gee, what have I said?
Let's leave him alone now, and something delightful might happen.
All right. Strike while the iron's hot, Henry.
You mustn't mind Mother.
Just don't let him put you behind the eight ball, Hank.
Have I thought that maybe you could move to Philadelphia, perhaps?
Why, I think Philly's great, but, well...
Majesté de la Cour de Paix, et avocat du Conseil d'État.
friends call him Rob Bear.
That's obvious. But what's he saying?
It can't be pure French because I don't understand it.
Entree?
Hello.
Why, Pinky, I thought that ship of ours took you to England.
It did, but I simply couldn't get away from you, you little charmer.
Monsieur, je suis Monsieur Robert Lamontour, magistrat de la Cour de Paix, et avocat de Monsieur Destin. Macaque!
Oh, thank you.
This French gentleman is a monsieur, but what he's here for is beyond us.
What do you want with Miss Lee?
Monsieur, je...
Let's not start that again.
Well, I think he's a solicitor.
What's that?
I don't know, but in America you can get pinched for doing it. Maybe he wants it too.
Ah, the tiara of our client, Lady Beekman.
Oh, no, you don't.
Are you representing Lady Beekman?
Oui, and if I did not get her tiara back, I would have to call for the police.
Well, ladies, I'll just be on my way, monsieur.
Ladies, I'm here for a clergyman who for 35 years has passionately loved her husband and been faithful to him in all kinds of weather, even in England.
Who's that?
It's a policeman.
Now don't get excited. It can't be any worse than what's already in here. Oh, yes, it can.
Bubba!
Are we in your way, boys?
My son! There sits the terrible creatures who have committed the terrible crime against our client!
Hey, Papa! She's as pretty as a doll!
She is? Oh, but you're right, my son! She's adorable!
And this little brunette, she is as chic as anything!
Charming, but charming!
Will you ask Robert here why he was crying just now?
Papa, you have been crying.
Yes, my son. Whenever I think that poor unhappy lady beat when I cry.
What do you do when you look at her?
Mademoiselle is as witty as she is charming.
Hey, Papa! Why not ask these charming young ladies out with us tonight? To the gala, the opening of the Prix Fatinat, eh?
Wonderful! And we charge into the expense account of our dear friend, Lady B.
Magnifique!
And now, boys, if you'll excuse us,
we have a previous engagement.
But what about tonight?
Well, you could stop by for cocktails later. We're having a couple of people drop in.
Merci, mademoiselle.
Long live our American!
All right, come on up. Lorelei's here. Good God, Lorelei, it's Gus.
Mr. Esmond, in Paris?
Right here in this hotel. Guess we should have opened these things up, babe.
Dorothy, what's wrong?
Plenty, listen to this. I don't care what you've done. I love you and I'm coming over to marry you. The hell with father.
You said that?
It's right here.
Mr. Esmond still loves me. Daddy still loves me. Daddy, Daddy! Daddy!
Cut it out, sister. It looks like I've been a chumpy down the line.
Perhaps I'd better be going.
Who are you?
He belongs to Dorothy.
That's right, Gus. He's my Henry.
And who are you?
Me no speak English. What?
Is that so?
You're just a French father and son trying to teach me about the French.
I'm not surprised. Just a minute. What's going on here?
We're celebrating our engagement.
Who said we were engaged?
I just read it now in your cablegram.
Just now? I sent that cable over a week ago.
Well, I'm busy.
So it seems. What's that?
Oh, it's just a small old zipper, Mr. Dressman.
Just a small old zipper? Why, you two-timing, disloyal, double-crossing little cheat? Gloria, did you say you wanted to open in the free talent? Well, you're going to. I'll pay him to put you on. I'll make you the hottest thing in this town.
Daddy, I haven't done anything wrong. Not even in Paris.
That's your story. Let's go, sweetheart.
No, come back, Daddy.
All right, Mr. Esmond.
I wouldn't marry you now if you were the last millionaire in the whole wide world. And some of these days, just wait and see. He's gonna come crawling back to me. Like one done wrong, the one who done me wrong, the one who done me wrong.
Plates and a couple of glasses of warm milk.
Okay.
Shall we dance, Bunny?
Why not? It's excellent exercise.
She's playing with dynamite. Aren't we having fun?
Do you think I'd better cut in on Mr. Gage?
Well, not you. You stay out of it. Here we go, fellas.
Hey, Blondie. Who's the new bankroll?
Good evening, Mr. Esmond. I'd like for you to meet Mr. Gage, the Zipper King.
Oh, so you've crowned her Queen of the Zippers, have you?
I resent that.
Break it up, fellas. Come along, Dorothy, will you please look after Bunny?
Okay, honey, but be careful. I'll take care of this.
Slip me that hunk of ice, will ya?
Take your hands off her, you cad.
Hand it over.
All right, I will.
There's your chance! Go seize my property!
And what's it for you?
Here, Mr. Esmond, just take it.
Thanks.
Good evening, Robert.
Nonsense.
Really?
Metallo!
I should like to warn everybody here that this self-styled lady is a swindler and a thief.
Your dad!
And the stupidest of all her dupes is my idiot husband.
Well, good evening, Mrs. Dunlap.
Phyllis, my dear, I only brought these girls in here to get them out of the night air, I swear.
Francis, come with me.
Phyllis, this is not cricket.
Come with me!
Hand back that hunk of camphor, will ya?
Fine, I will.
What did you do to have to rape this?
Never mind.
I resent your insinuations against me, sir!
Oh, so you want to fight it?
If you insist.
Giddy, giddy, giddy!
I'll warn you, I'm champion of White Plains in the heavyweight division.
White Plains? I once cleaned out Dinny Moore's.
2-1 Dinny! 2-1 to Dinny Moore!
No, please! You'll kill my daddy!
Your daddy?
Come on!
Gentlemen! Gentlemen!
Mesdames et messieurs! We have the pleasure to present to you the great American artist, Miss Gloria Starr! Come on!
Come on, everybody! Give the little girl a great big hand! She's sensational!
She's not sensational! She's all over black and blue spots! Cause all she ever does is practice! And she isn't even well groomed!
Oh, yeah? Just wait till you see the outfit I staked her to!
Thank you.
this time of night?
What are you doing sitting in the lobby spying on me? Besides, it's not night, it's morning. And if I'd prefer to be alone in Paris, it's my own choice.
Everything seems to be your own choice. Ever since you met that guy who gave you that tiara.
It wasn't a gift. I bought and paid for it with my own borrowed money.
You borrowed money?
Yes, and I was going to let you pay for it, but now you can't. And I don't want you to do anything for me ever again.
Gee, and for you I split with my father and the Esmond Button Corporation.
No, you didn't. You didn't split with your Esmond Button business.
Sure I did. Pop told me I had to take my pick, so I gave up Esmond Buttons for you.
And was your father angry?
Angry? Nearly blew him out of his wheelchair. Why didn't you tell me you shot a guy in Little Rock?
No.
Shot, and were arrested, and tried.
No, Daddy.
Is it true, or isn't it?
Well, Mr. Esmond, it was like this. I wasn't reared in a mansion in Old Virginia like I told you. I was only reared in a small town near Little Rock. But finally the mortgage on our house began to get quite close, so I decided to move to Little Rock and study how to be a stenographer to help Mom around. And before I left, Mama gave me all her advice about being good. But Papa didn't think that advice would be enough, so in case it wasn't, he gave me his revolver.
Yeah, go on.
Well, from the moment when I got there, there wasn't a single gentleman in Little Rock who ever tried to help me study the way you do.
No fooling.
And then, one day, a gentleman called Mr. Jennings and paid a call on the business college because he needed a stenographer. So he looked over all the college girls and he picked me up. So my teacher told him I'd only been there less than a week and I hadn't a little bit to learn yet. But Mr. Jennings said he was only a lawyer anyway and I really didn't need to know much.
How do you like that?
Well, I needed to have money to send home to Mama, so I told him I'd accept his offer if I could bring my revolver to work with me.
And the guy agreed?
He said any revolver of mine was always more than welcome.
Well, how do you like that?
But from the moment I got there, I realized Mr. Jennings' mind was never on his work. I mean, I warned him and warned him, but one day when he locked the office door and threw the key out of the window, I had quite a bad case of hysterics. And when I came out of it, it seems I had a revolver in my hand. And it seems that revolver had shot Mr. Jennings.
Gee.
The bullet only went in one hand, but it came right out the other. But he called me names I couldn't repeat, even to myself.
Gee, what a rat.
And Mr. Esmond, you'll never know how terrible it is to have a district attorney against you at a trial.
Oh, I bet it is. And that.
But the gentlemen of the jury were lovely to me. And when my lawyer pointed at me and told them nearly all of them had a mother, they cried. And they hardly had time to get out before they came right back again and acquitted me. And when I kissed Judge Hubbard, he had tears in his eyes. And he told me to just let the whole thing blow over and change my name to Lorelei, which is the name of a girl who became famous for sitting on a rock in Germany. So I don't care what your father says. I shot Mr. Jennings to save the only thing a girl has that's sacred.
Look, I know, honey, but if you hadn't let Pop hear about it from a total stranger.
Your father didn't want you to marry me, even before he knew I could shoot.
Gee, but I leave you alone for 2 minutes and you go and pick up some new chunk.
Oh, Mr. Esmond, it isn't my fault.
Gentlemen prefer blondes. Did they discuss her
Mr. Esmond, until his father asks me to.
Then you'll never marry Mr. Esmond.
I'm afraid you don't know the old boy like I do.
Don't you worry, I have my plans.
What plans?
Never mind.
There you go again, keeping secrets from me.
But this plan is wonderful, and it's all for you.
Did someone say we were gonna have a little drinky?
Sure.
It's getting late. Don't you want to say goodnight, Mother?
I don't want to go to bed. I can do that at home.
Sure she doesn't. Stick around, kid.
Okay.
I say, Mr. Gage, have you found a good barber in Paris yet?
No, not yet.
I know this guy. In New York, at the Astor.
You don't mean Joe Nicolini?
Sure I do. And incidentally, there's a great fight next week at the Garden. Dempsey!
Speaking of sports, do you know Mr. Connie Mack?
Yeah. 50 years in baseball and still going.
I'm with the Philadelphia team.
They've got a pretty fair chance of winning the next World Series.
The World Series.
Gee, New York has everything.
You know what the matter with us is? We're all homesick.
Now
We're still waiting on that belief.
Lorelei refuses to marry Gus unless his father consents.
Good morning, Mrs. Buffett. Where is Lorelei?
She's in the powder room having a massage.
Hi, Madam. They're serving carrots in the hunch room.
Good morning, dear.
Good morning, Henry.
Mother, have you had breakfast?
Yes, Henry. A brioche and a prairie oyster.
Good for you.
I'm so sorry, Mr. Esmond, but the police say that the casino belongs to the public. They can't keep it roped off for much longer.
Yeah, look, I know. I'm straightening that little matter out with the mayor as we speak.
Dorothy, if Gus can put through Lorelei's wedding, why can't we make it a double one?
Hank, please, stop tempting me.
Dorothy, why won't you marry us?
Because I'd make such a lousy millionaireess.
But what makes you think I'm a millionaire?
He's kidding, isn't he?
Oh, my, no. All family's funds are in my name.
And Mother's so careless about money, I may even have to go to work someday.
Oh, no, Hank, not you.
Why not? You've been working for years.
That's different. I'm a girl.
You see, Henry? She can't resist you.
Sweetheart.
Okay, Hank. But don't say I didn't warn you. Hey, the joint spin!
You did!
Pop made it after all.
Who was it? Dance had me dragged through the streets like a common criminal!
Mr. Esmond, I'm Henry Spofford.
Huh?
And we asked the mayor to do this for your own good.
My own what?
So you could meet a little lady we all love, especially Gus.
So that's it, is it?
Pop, the least you can do is speak to Lorelei. Then you can...
Wait a minute, Mrs. Spofford. I made my own way into the modern world, and I don't intend to let my son throw away his career on a girl who's never had a constructive thought in her life. Now let me out of here! You the young lady in question?
Yes, sir. I've looked forward to meeting you for a long, long time.
We have nothing at all in common.
We have a lot that's in common. We have your buttons and your son.
Is that our own model 306?
No, it's number 302. You'll see, Mr. Esmond, I know more about this empire than you think I do. Now just you listen to this. Esmond's buttons are beautiful. Esmond's buttons are strong.
Try to tell you, Pop, but you just wouldn't listen.
step to our wedding.
And I'm proud of the alliance.
He's walking!
A miracle! You see?
Get out of here, Lorelai.
Just ask your son.